Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rick Starr, and I'd like to welcome you to the Tuesday evening meeting of our Golden Speakers Toastmasters Club. Now, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the president of our club, Jean Symington Craig.
Thank you, Rick. Greetings, fellow Toastmasters. I think we don't have guests right now, but we do have new members, and we're going to welcome them and viewers at home. We're here at Golden Speakers Toastmasters. We meet every Tuesday evening, 7:45 to 9:15, at the Hy-Vee Community Room on the west side of the store at the end of the ice cream aisle. You can get your ice cream before you come in, eat it, and then come in, or you can wait till after the meeting and then buy it on your way out. Either way works for us. We do have brand new members who came last week as guests and at the end became members. And we'd like to have just a little bit of an introduction. We're going to ask you to just stand and give us just a couple of words as to why you decided to go ahead and join after coming last week. And this is Feng and Wonjin.
Wow. Right.
So we'll have Feng. Feng. Why don't you stand first?
Good evening, everyone. And my name is Feng Zhao. And because my last name sounds like Johnny, so you can call me Johnny for
okay.
And for the reason I decided to join as a member for the Toastmaster, because I think at first it can improve my English first. Then it can help me to improve my speed, presentation skills. That's the main reason.
Okay,
thank you.
Okay, good evening, everyone. I'm president at everyone. And my name is Hui Jin. And I also have an English name. It's Michael. Because I'm a fan of Michael Jordan. I'm former NBA superstar. So, I came here just for improving my English skills and making friends. So that's why I come here.
Well, welcome. Yes, there it is. And you'll both be meeting with Rick afterwards, getting your icebreaker set up, because that's the best way, is just to dive right in and start working out those speaking and presentation muscles. Really, really good. The mission of a Toastmasters Club is to provide a mutually supportive and positive learning environment in which every member has the opportunity to develop oral communication and leadership skills, which in turn foster self-confidence and personal growth. Could I just see hands, anyone who's noticed even just a smidgen increase of self-confidence since they joined Toastmasters? Okay, I kind of made that an easy one. So I thought I'd get pretty much full hands there. That is a goal that we have here at Toastmasters, is to build not only our presentation and speaking skills and our leadership skills, but in the process, build our self-confidence, which in turn we take with us into other parts of our life. And that's how we actually end up growing and expanding throughout our world. With that, I would like to welcome up our Toastmaster for the evening, Mr. Art Atkinson.
Thank you, Jean. Good evening, Toastmasters and viewers at home. One of my principal duties will be to alert you to the need to find this device in your pocket and put it on silent mode or turn it off so that it doesn't interrupt our proceedings here tonight, as I am now doing with mine. My job as Toastmaster is something of a master of ceremonies. I'll conduct the meeting and be here at the lectern between other speakers. One of my duties is to introduce the various role players who will be helping to run various aspects of the meeting. The first role player I'd like to introduce is our timer. Mr. Dan Craig is functioning as timer this evening. Dan, would you please explain that role?
My role as timer is to keep track of the length of all the speeches, table topics, and evaluations that occur tonight. Our speeches are typically 5 to 7 minutes long, and for that week, we get a green light at 5 minutes, a yellow light at 6, and a red light at 7, which would remain on until the end of the talk. Table topics, when we get to that, is 1 to 2 minutes, a green light at 1, yellow light a minute 30, red light and 2 minutes, and there's a 30-second grace period for table topics for all the speeches that occur. Evaluations are 2 to 3 minutes, the green light's at 2 minutes, the yellow light 2 minutes 30 seconds, the red light is at 3 minutes. And I'll give a report at the end of the meeting.
Our grammarian this evening is Ms. Pia Fritsch. Pia, would you explain your role? Thank you.
So my role as a grammarian is to listen to the language used by the members during the meeting and to make note of exceptionally good or bad usages of the language and to give a brief report at the end of the meeting about what you heard or observed and also to listen to the word of the day, use of the word of the day, and report about the
those people who use that.
What
is the word?
Please tell us. I chose a novel. It's a noun. It could be words or ideas that combine strength with sweetness. It originates from a drink made of wine mixed with honey in ancient Greece. And I use it to describe my favorite drink, which is coffee, which has much enamel.
Okay. Pronounce it for us again, please. Thank you. Our off counter tonight is Andal. Miss Andal Krishna.
I'll be keeping note of words and sounds used as a filler words by anyone who speaks during the meeting. Words like like, you know, so, but, and repeated words or false start will be noted, and I'll give a report at the end of the meeting.
Our general evaluator this evening will be Mr. Rick Starr, and we will hear from him later in the meeting. We will also hear later in the meeting from our greeter joke master, Mr. Will Burns. Now, on to the next section of our meeting. We have prepared speeches this evening. The first one will be by Mr. Ryan Cronin-Miller, and here to introduce his project is his evaluator, Emery Styron.
Thank you, Art, and good evening, fellow members, new members, viewers at home. Prana is a sustainable living graduate of Maharishi University of Management, and now is doing his second term of Green Iowa AmeriCorps. He kills time by playing tennis, and not while you're on the job, right? And he's been an active member of Toastmasters for some time, and he's finished his competent communicator and is now working on his advanced storytelling manual. He's presenting tonight assignment number 3, the moral of the story. His objectives are to understand that a story can be entertaining yet display moral values. Entertaining but have moral values, I would call that an example of a noble. Another objective, to create a new story that offers a lesson or moral. To tell the story using skills developed in the 2 previous projects, and his time will be 4 to 6 minutes. Connor's title tonight is The Battle, Anticipating a Win. Please.
Is it 4 to 6 or 5 to 7?
It says 4 to 6 right here.
Okay. 4 to 6.
Okay. That's what it is. Anticipating a Win. Please welcome Ronnie Miller.
Telling you a story tonight, and the story is based on truth, but the characters, places, and times may be different than the actual story. So I'm going to be telling you a story, and it's based on, like I said, based on a true story, but those involved, will be different than the actual story. So let's see. Okay, over 100 years ago, there was a battle in Costa Rica, and Russia had an unsettled debt, and it was basically a financial debt that was owed, the country was owed a lot of money from Costa Rica, and you're all familiar with Costa Rica, this country, Central America, Russia, Europe. So Russia was owed a lot of money from Costa Rica, and debt was unpaid, and Costa Rica refused to pay the debt. Somewhat similar to Puerto Rico today, or other countries, that the debt, there's a lot of unpaid debt in the world, and it's not uncommon for a country to refuse to pay a debt. But Russia decided to bring troops down into Costa Rica to push them into paying their debt. And the debt, they brought Spain and Britain with them, because they were also money. And Costa Rica has a very limited military. They don't spend a lot of money on military. They are a very low military country. So they're like, Russia, Spain, Britain's troops all show up. Costa Rica's like, we're not paying. And so Spain and Britain kind of give them a reprieve, and they head off back to their home base. And Costa Rica, Russia could have followed suit, but they decided to stage a siege on Costa Rica's land because they were interested in having land, money, something to repay this debt. Russia has a larger military than Costa Rica, so we're looking at a battle that's an easy win for Russia. Basically, Russia is going to swoop in, knock out their forces, and Costa Rica is going to leave their land for Russia. So Russia has a 5,000 troop army, 5,000 troops, and Costa Rica has about 2,500. And so today, April 4th, 1861, a battle goes from Russia's, they're bringing in their forces, they got their hubris and their enamel, I guess. Maybe not sweet, but they're definitely strong. And so they're bringing their forces in. They've sailed their ships, and they push Costa Rica's forces back to a small town in the middle of the country. And Costa Rica, their forces are a little bit dwindled, but they still are doing okay. And the next morning, when the battle continues, Costa Rica, their forces,
their defense, there's defense is a strong offense, right? Best defense is, no, sorry, best offense is a strong defense. So they have, whatever, however it goes, they have a great defense. And like a soccer team, you know, you've got your soccer players, they're all fighting, and you know, you have a good defense, you can win the game. So Costa Rica, they end up having, they win the battle, they 10 times the amount of troops for Russia, 10 times the amount of troops are lost in Russia's battle than is. Russia loses 10 times as many troops as Costa Rica's forces. So that was unexpected. How did that happen? Costa Rica's military is fairly weak. You know, Russia's kind of strong. And so what's going on? How did this happen? I don't really know, but so the battle ended. Russia retreats. They go back without their debt, without their land, nothing. And so if you have any historical knowledge of what happened here in the 1860s, this story was based on different countries involved. And like I said at the beginning, it was based on a true story, but the reason it's based on a true story. And so the countries involved were actually Napoleon's France and Costa Rica and Mexico. So, Day of the Dead, Cinco de Mayo, May 5th, happened today, today's May 11th.
The 10th.
Today is the 10th. So, I think today, 6 days later, I thought it would be appropriate to kind of give a little history lesson on what happened, what actually happened on May 5th, since most people think it's Mexican Independence Day. Independence Day, independence from the occupation, but was not actually true. And America celebrates the Cinco de Mayo. It's like, all right, celebrate, get drunk, woohoo, it's Cinco de Mayo. Really what happened, it was a battle between France and Mexico. And it didn't actually, wasn't actually a day of independence for Mexico. And it's kind of unusual that we celebrate it in America when really it's just a day for a small battle that was won. And the moral of the story here is something that I live in my life, and I kind of a mantra or a phrase that I remember in situations: to prepare for the worst and expect the best. That's the moral of the story. You can be doing a job interview, you could be, you know, getting ready for a sports game, be getting ready for a Toastmasters speech, and you might have the easiest expectations, and you walk in and then, you know, you drop the ball. Or if you have the worst expectations that it's going to go terribly, and then you prepare for anything, the worst, you expect the best. Prepare for the worst and expect the best. So, thank you.
Speaker is Jean Symington Craig, president of the club. Here to introduce Jean's project visitor evaluator, George Straub.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Greetings, fellow Toastmasters, new members, viewers at home. Jean Symington Craig has been a Toastmaster since 2006. First, let's go through the evaluation guide. Did a misstep there. Apologies. In project number 9 that she'll be giving, I'm going to be looking for a few things, such as projection of sincerity and conviction, phrasing in terms of the audience's self-interest instead of just her own, and if she'll capture her interest in the beginning, even all the way through, perhaps she'll even display monomal. I suspect she will. And if she uses facts and logical reasoning to support her views. She has been a Toastmaster since 2006. Not only a Toastmaster, a DTM, very exciting, a distinguished Toastmaster. She has served in a variety of officer roles within the Golden Speakers Club and is the current president. In addition, she serves as club liaison at the Conscious Communicators Toastmaster Club at the Iowa State Penitentiary Maximum Security Facility in Fort Madison, where she is also a member, dual membership. Most excellent. Tonight, Jean is doing a competent communicator project, number 9, Persuade with Power. She will use this speech to begin the process of selecting new Golden Speakers officers for the upcoming Toastmaster year, starting July 1st, 2016, and ending June 30th, 2017. Please help me warmly welcome Jean. The title of her speech is Golden Speaker Officer. Your turn, your opportunity.
A good leader inspires people to have confidence in the leader. A great leader inspires people to have confidence in themselves. If your actions inspire others to dream more, to learn more, to do more, and to become more, you are a leader. The first quote was Lao Tzu. The second quote was John Quincy Adams. Tonight, we're going to begin the selection process of our upcoming officers for our next year. This is normally a committee that is chaired by our immediate past president, who is Louis Denbaugh. Since Louis is out of the state for the time being, I have agreed to chair this committee. First, I'd like to have our current officers in the room please stand so we can acknowledge them and give them a round of applause.
Whoa.
We have Rick as our Vice President of Education, Emery Styron is our Vice President of Membership, Will is our Vice President of Public Relations and also Secretary dual role. We have Dan Craig as our Treasurer, and Raven Garland has been our Sergeant at Arms when she is here. We've all pitched in. It's been a really great team, and I've been the president. In your competent communicator manual, in the back, there is a whole section on officer responsibilities. Anyone taking a look at that? It's about page 76 to 78 in there. I suggest that you take a look at that. It's very full of information. This is the section that's the what. What does it take to be an officer? I have some cheat sheets here, and you've all been given one of these, which is also another form of a cheat sheet. We're going to call this the preference slip. It's got little summary bullet points of what it takes to be an officer. I want to mention quickly, I'm going to go through the officers. We have 7 officers. As the president, obviously, I oversee the meeting. I offer encouragement, sometimes a little stand-up humor. In the outside of the meeting, I am running the president is running the executive meeting. And we're also really focused, which is once a month, we're also focused on developing the Distinguished Club program for the club. And I gave that talk about a month ago as to what all that is, the 10 goals that we're all achieving each year. The Vice President of Education actually plans the meeting. And the agendas that you have here, these are all compliments of our Vice President of Education. We have a software that we use. It's called Easy Speak, and it helps the Vice President of Education create the agenda, keep track of who has accomplished what, and when were the roles last covered, et cetera, et cetera. It's a very good program. It really helps cut down the work. Our Vice President of Education is also focused on scheduling people for various speaking opportunities and just generally helping people with the educational track. The Vice President of Membership is the person that we refer guests to explain the program, start answering questions, to accept membership dues and also applications, and to really help facilitate guests becoming members and getting on the track. We also have our Vice President of Membership do a couple of extra things. He or she assigns mentors to new members so that there's someone in the club that can be a coach and a mentor. It helps the new member. It also helps the existing member have a coaching, mentoring experience. These are all muscles that we want to learn how to work. Emory also makes sure, or our Vice President of Membership also makes sure that our new members get scheduled quickly into having their first project, their icebreaker. Our Vice President of Public Relations is basically connecting with the local media. We've used Fairfield Ledger, we have used the Ledger before, we're not using it too much, the Weekly Reader, but also particularly our Facebook page. That seems to be where we really like to have a lot of focus. Our secretary takes the minutes of our monthly meetings. Will has done a really good job with that, keeps the minutes in a good, accessible place, and also submits the new officers at the end of the year. We'll do that in June. Our treasurer takes the dues and the applications and enters them into the Toastmasters.org website, updates our membership. Twice a year, he does the annual club dues collection and posting, and then in between, he accepts the new member applications and puts those in there. He also takes care of the bank reconciliation. We do have a bank account, money that comes in and goes out. He takes care of that, and he reports to the officers as to if we want to spend money, do we have some money? Do we have the money to do that? Finally, our sergeant at arms. That's really pretty much focused at the meeting. It's the person who comes and oversees the setup of the room. I always say oversees it because we're all here helping, and then also oversees the breakdown afterwards and makes sure that all of our materials are kept up to date and are plentiful and available. So those are our different officer roles. Quickly, and we'll have a chance to talk about that. That's the what. Now I want to talk a little bit about the how and the why be an officer. I'll tell you my story really quick. I was a member in 2006, never been a Toastmaster before. I was chugging along, doing my competent communicator and just learning. And about 10 months later, I was asked to be the president of the club. And I thought, I went, well, I don't know how to do that. And secondly, I don't have time to do that. I'm busy with a lot of other things. And third is, well, can't somebody else do that? Because I'm just a newbie. Those are the kinds of responses we can have. So let's take those one by one. First, I don't know what to do. How do we address that? First, every officer gets a manual that explains all of your duties, and it also explains all the other duties of all the other officers, so you actually see where your job fits into the entire club structure. Secondly, we have officer training twice a year. We actually go somewhere else and we get trained with other Toastmasters on our job. Third, we have the members that have had that job before that are in the club, that are there to help you and to mentor you if you have any questions. We have a very strong tradition of that. So you really can't say, I don't know what to do. Actually, you can say, I don't know what to do, but that won't last for very long. You will learn what to do, and we all had to do that. Secondly is, I don't have time. The officer positions are designed to be, not to be a burden, and they're very straightforward. So here's what's required. One is, in addition to just fulfilling your duties, we have a once a month officer executive meeting, and we do it usually the first Tuesday of the month, right before this meeting. Usually about 6:45, 7:30, and we meet and we go over things. So that's one requirement. Second requirement is the officer training twice a year, where we basically go on a road trip, we bond with each other, we have fun, and we go off and we meet other Toastmasters, and hasn't it been interesting, Rick?
It has been.
It's very interesting. Emery, didn't you like it when we went?
Yeah, we eat sandwiches in a very big hurry.
Yeah, and afterwards we'll go somewhere and we'll eat lunch and then keep going. So anyway. And then there's, in between, there can be emails. If we have an issue that's coming up or something we need to take care of, we will have emails in the middle of that. So it's like anything else. Once you start to learn what you're doing, you get more efficient, it takes less time, and you actually, since you see the value of what you're doing, you make the time. It's just like that. Third response people can say is, well, can't somebody else do it? Basically, what we do here is, the principle is, many hands make light work. As a member of the club, you can expect to be an officer, asked to be an officer every about 3 years, because that's how we rotate through, 7 people times 20 to 30 people like that. So that's how we do that. And actually, it's important because we want to make sure that nobody gets burned out and that everybody has the opportunity to develop leadership skills. And that's what happens when you're an officer. I'm going to tell you another story. My dad, so I grew up with my dad, and my dad's view was that if you did something, you got more points if you did something that you didn't like, but you did it because it was your duty. Now, following that logic, the person who had the most points at the end of their life was the person who had the most miserable life. Okay. I didn't buy that. I just didn't think that made sense. So I come at it from a different perspective. I come at it with more from the benefit side. Like, what's in it for me? How could I grow? What could I learn? Where's the charm? And maybe even some fun that I could have. That motivates me a bit more. Okay. But let's take a look at the duty perspective. If you happen to be like my dad and duty is something that appeals to you. See, I can't even remember it because it doesn't appeal to me. First of all, when you did the Toastmaster promise, you actually promised to serve as an officer when requested. So that's one thing. Secondly, if you enjoy what happens here, you have an obligation to support the club and help it to run. And basically, we need you to step up and help so that people can cycle out. All of our officers have done a great job this year. We need to turn the page and let new people come in. So that's the duty perspective. I can say, you promised to serve as an officer in the Toastmaster promise. I've got you right there, right there. But I like to put it a little more friendly. So let's talk about it from the benefit perspective. As I've mentioned before, humans do things in groups. That's how they accomplish things. And that's going to happen a lot in your life. You're going to have a lot of opportunities and a lot of incentives to get better with group skills and practice leadership. That's what being an officer in this club is about, is working on your interactive group skills so that you're better able to function that way with the multi-diverse people that you're going to run into in your life. It's fulfilling to uphold and support the club. People that are growing, it's always wonderful when we have new members. It's wonderful to help them start on their path and see them grow. As an officer, you're in a position to do that. Finally, I'm just going to say that being an officer builds that self-confidence that I talked about earlier in the meeting. You're an officer of a number one club. It's such a privilege to be an officer of this club. Look at this. This is incredible. All of these ribbons are demonstrative of achievement. Animo. It's just, so it's a privilege to be an officer in the line of this tradition of this club. So the self-confidence, when you are an officer, you can stand tall. Backbone up, shoulders back, head up, sparkle in your eyes, unless you've been over in the wine section, but no, seriously, sparkle in your eyes. This comes from being an officer in this club. At the end of my year of being president, I was president 2007-2008, I didn't want to give it up. I went from whoa, to, I'm just getting the hang of it and it's really getting fun, because I felt the strength of what had happened for me during that year. I thought about staging a coup, but I decided I'd better just gracefully put myself out to pasture. It's been a privilege to serve as your president again this year. I encourage all of you to step up, take advantage, expand yourself by becoming an officer of this club for all the reasons that we've gone over. The preference slip that I showed you, this right here, want to collect one of these from everyone tonight. What you're going to do is you're going to put your name up here and then indicate with a 1, 2, or 3 which officer position in order of preference you would be interested in. And then I will collect them. And we'll have it. The nominating committee will take these slips, will look at what you're requesting and put it all into the big picture, and then we'll present a final slate of officer candidates May 24th, and then we will vote on May 30th. Okay. How much time do I have?
You've got 16 minutes so far.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to just open up right now for questions on any of this, because this is the time to ask questions. Rick.
I don't have a question. I just have a couple of comments. I belong to this club, and I'm a member of the Cambridge, a club at Cambridge, which is a corporate club. And I've been an officer in both clubs for a number of years. And Jean was saying, and it's really true, you gain a lot of satisfaction, a lot of fulfillment by being an officer in a club. You're a member of a small team, you're actually the focus, a member of the leadership of the club. It's not that much work. As Jean said, meet once a month for about 45 minutes, and some duties during the meeting, some duties outside the meeting. It really is, title of your speech a lot. It really is an opportunity. And the second point is, if you're going to continue on with the education programs in Toastmasters, one of the requirements for advanced leadership award, or maybe advanced leadership bronze, is holding an officer position within a club. And so you can, this is a pretty easy thing to do. Just by being an officer, you get credit for it. But anyone who is thinking about it, I would urge you to consider it. It's something very, very fulfilling.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rick. So there we have a testimonial. It's a good testimonial. Do you have something?
I actually have a question.
Okay.
You did a wonderful job, Madam President, of outlining the seven roles here. I was wondering if you could speak briefly on the eighth role, immediate past president, and how they would help the president.
Okay, very good. The job of president is actually a two-year commitment. The first year, you're the president. And the second year, you're like the grandpa or the grandma. You're the consultant to the board. You're not a voting member, but you are there to offer guidance, to help the new president, the new officers understand a little bit more what they're doing. So you see all the different ways as a new officer when you don't know what you're doing, and that's par for the course. Other places, you'll say, someone will say, well, would you do this? And you say, I don't know how to do it. And they'll go, okay, well, we'll get somebody else. Not here. Here, we just go, no problem. You're going to learn. You'll learn. But the immediate past president, the IPP, is the person who's there to help, just oversee and add some advice and be the wise.
Perspective.
The wise, yes, the perspective. Some perspective, because past president has been through the whole cycle. So we are a club where people step up and they do jobs over and over again, and they've been in different positions. So we have a lot of background here. And clubs will do things slightly differently in different locations. So if you end up going somewhere else, you may see the jobs done slightly differently, but basically they're all pretty much going to be about the same. So that's a really good question. What else?
Do you ever with the do you ever work with other groups, like other Toastmasters, you know, clubs as an officer that like you know, are there other opportunities to work with other clubs? Not to join other clubs, but to like, you know, we have these contests and things, do you meet with other clubs or is it mostly just like kind of in this club?
As an officer?
Yeah.
Okay, so as an officer, we're all, you know, as clubs to clubs, you can always visit any club you want. You can be in contests. But the officers, where we come together is the twice a year training out there and the district conference that happens in May. We have a big district conference. Toastmasters come together. There's you can become what's called an area director, which is one level up. Rick has been the area director this year. You have another kind of meeting where you meet other officers. So it's a whole leadership track. Toastmasters is, the tagline is Toastmasters, where leaders are made. So there's a big emphasis on developing leadership. I don't know if that answers your question.
Yeah, I was just curious. Yeah, it's like
the area director job, as an example, it's a requirement that you go visit the clubs that are in your area, and that's fun. You get to go visit them and
right.
be the visiting celebrity and check out what they're doing and things like that.
Hold the area contest.
Hold the area contest. It's
like the Jefferson County or
right. If Rick had been here, he was just a little bit, you know, past being able to do the area contest. But remember, Ben Traxel came here and did that. That's the division.
Yep. Okay.
So there are leadership opportunities moving up into the district. But this is where you start. This is where you start, is at the club.
But the club officers themselves don't have any particular requirement to operate outside the club.
No,
with
they
other
don't.
Clubs.
No. They don't. We just, at the club level, we're just getting together and we're thinking, what do the members want? What will help our club grow? Where do we need to put some attention like that? And there's a whole calendar of events, things that happen during a Toastmaster year. And the president is focused on that. And you guys are just working to make that all happen. Like this month, we're working on officers. Does that make sense? Okay. So the tough love part of it, as the president, your current president, is we do need to have these roles filled. So it's much better if you kind of get your mind around it and say, yep, these are the things I want, as opposed to having me have to come visit you in the middle of the night. Now, see, that was my attention getter. I know people are listening if people started chuckling. Did you guys get that? You don't want me coming to visit you at night, in the middle of the night, because, you know, it may be painful. Okay, so they're getting used to my sense of humor. All right, so that's that. But honestly, the benefit is you can't know how much growth you're going to experience in your body until you actually become an officer of this. Really, we are tied for number one in the district. 90 plus clubs, we are tied for number one. It's huge. So we really do know what we're doing. It's just fun to get on board. With that, yes?
Well,
I've got a yellow light, so.
Okay. The president also has this continuous focus on the Distinguished Club Program and steps into the tradition of strength that we have of going back years of mastering that.
Right. Yes.
And not everyone in the room knows just how critical that is.
We've been a very successful club. And we have pared down what works and what doesn't work. So we really have good tracks to run on for what works. So it's really just stepping in, being teachable, doing your part, and knowing that you're helping your fellow members, which is what we all agreed to do, to support and promote each other. All right, so you've got your form. Please let me have that before you leave. And with that, Mr. Toastmaster, I'll hand back to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jean. Now, if the timer would please give us 2 minutes to work at developing an evaluation for Jean on the evaluation sheets that you should have on your chairs. There should be one of these available. Thank you. Now, Toastmasters, Mr. Timer, would you please tell us which of our two speakers is qualified from a time perspective?
Tonight, only one speaker qualified, that was Jean.
Then there will be no need for us to vote for the best speaker of the evening. Now I would like to call upon our general evaluator, Rick Starr, who will conduct the next section of the meeting. Right.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, viewers at home. In Toastmasters, we learn our communication skills in two ways. One, we give speeches, both prepared speeches and impromptu speeches called table topics. And the other is we get evaluated by our peers, by our fellow Toastmasters. Toastmasters has no paid instructors, no one who goes around teaching us how to speak. We teach ourselves. And an important part of learning to speak is being evaluated. So we're going to start off with Emery, who will evaluate Prana's speech. Thank you, Rick. Good evening again, fellow Toastmasters and members and viewers at home. I'd like to first congratulate Prana. I believe this was one of the stronger performances I have seen you give, Prana.
Thanks.
Your self-confidence, your assurance was very strong as you came up here. And you opened had a very nice opening. I want to tell you a story. We all like stories. I'm going to go through the 4 points or 5 points of evaluation, then I'll offer a few suggestions. Number one was the story presented simply and clearly. Not quite simply and clearly enough to my taste. I felt it was a little disjointed. Number two, how did the speaker capture and hold our interest? As I mentioned in a nice opening, that is crucial in any speech to grab the attention at the beginning. Connor also referenced the modern situation of Puerto Rico not being able to pay its debt, compared that to the story he was talking about with Costa Rica and Russia, gave us another way to grab on to what he was saying. And it was also seemed to me a David and Goliath type story of the small Costa Rica versus the big Russia, and a lot of us have a natural affinity for the underdog. Number three, were all the elements of a good story included? Plot, setting, characters, actions, etc. And were some missing? Well, I saw setting, plot, and action, but not many characters. We were talking about nations, entities, but it would have helped if we could have had some flesh and blood humans involved. Number four, how did the speaker use vocal variety to add to the story? Not a lot of vocal variety. Prana has a very nice, friendly delivery, and it kept our interest, but louder, softer would have helped. What was the twist to the story? Was it successful? Why or why not? A big twist, we find out that we weren't talking about Costa Rica and Russia, we were actually talking about Napoleon's France and Mexico. So that was a head-spinning twist to me. And Cinco de Mayo is not actually the day of independence for Mexico. So big twist, and then a moral on top, prepare for the worst and expect the best. I think that fit just fine. Quick suggestions, outline your speech. Boil it down to an opening, three steps or points, and a strong close. And once you give that close, stop right there. Don't make it mushy by adding any more. Your close could have been prepare for the worst, expect the best. And on that, I'll close. Thank you.
Memory. Now I'd like to introduce Stuart, who will give the evaluation of Jean's speech.
Fellow test masters, viewers at home, Jean. Well done. Perhaps this evaluation will be balanced by onomal. Onomalic evaluation. Look into that and see if that was proper usage of the word. Without a doubt, she projected sincerity and conviction and definitely a credible source of information about this topic. Why go to anyone else? She definitely phrased her appeal in terms of the audience's self-interest and perhaps could have been made stronger if it was woven more throughout. There was a definite building up to it, and also an increase in power of your voice and a slowing down of gestures to support the language. That's when it became really interesting, when you build momentum, when you got to the part of the self-interest. Oh, I perked up. Did the speech opening capture the audience's interest? It did. Perhaps you could have really gripped us by saying something like, become an officer in a number one club. Like, whoa, we're the best. Yeah, why not join up? So hook us right away. Without a doubt, factual, logical, reasonable support of your views, and your emotion, your enthusiasm, enthusiasm was clear throughout. And again, definitely more apparent in and forceful when you got to the middle part of the speech and when you really started tapping us about self-interest. And your humor, supported by the body language, that as well as including audience participation in the speech, and that really gets people to focus on the speaker. She's so good, she's effortlessly interacting with the audience, grabbing our attention that way, answering questions. Very smooth. I was persuaded to accept your views. And what I really liked about the speech was your passion for the club, your use of humor and the body language together. Again, I want to emphasize that and the progression of the power of your voice. And that's when I scooted in my chair. The homeless person is ramping it up. I'm glad you weren't yawning. Just a sneeze. It's hoping I could hold your attention while I was evaluating you. Very well done.
Now to the table topic section of the meeting, where we have an opportunity to do some impromptu speaking. And I'd like to introduce our table topics master, Mr. Will Burns.
Thank you, Rick. Table topics is the portion of the meeting where we get to speak off the cuff. Got two cups, so I should be pretty good at this. We'll see. But no, I won't actually be shooting this tonight. I don't know if it was mentioned, but I'll mention it now. The meeting theme tonight was first impressions. It's always very important to make first impressions in whatever scenario. And I have some props here to assist you with making a first impression. So I will call on a volunteer here. It's about to volunteer. Table topics. Do it.
Look what happened. Three.
All right. Go ahead and put this on.
Oh, I love that.
And I want you to give us a good first impression. That's the man. And go ahead and continue to impress us.
Will, after your dinner party and the wonderful cheese and the wine, and the smart black hat that you had on with your smoking jacket, even though you don't smoke, persuaded me to go out and get a similar hat. And has it improved the quality of my relationships? Because when I run out of things to say, I can just fiddle around with this hat. I can even approach someone else. I can describe what it's done for me, and I can, with great agility, to the more resistant person, I can put it on their head, and when it comes flying off, I can catch it and place it back on my beam, which, as you see, doesn't adequately fill the space. That's okay. Then it takes us on another adventure, and then I can look around my house for things to fit in this and try to go about my day and carefully tuck it in as it starts to fall around my ears and it tickles me. But the adventure must continue, and we must keep up appearances, because I do want to be at my best so I can be invited to another of your dinner parties so I can continue to get ideas based on your appearance. Sir.
A tough act to follow, but here at Golden Speakers, we shy away from danger, fear, from terror. I'll call up our next volunteer now. Pranam.
All right. Yeah.
These are all hats, I should
wear. Oh, that's good. That's great.
Go ahead and show us this kind of character.
Okay.
Well,
yes.
Yes.
Just because we have new people, can you be a little more specific as to what you're wanting people to do?
Take on the role
of this particular character wearing this hat and give us a good first impression. So basically take on the best qualities of the person. Or the worst qualities. So, yeah.
Right, okay.
Somebody wearing that hat. Mm. And I'll just explain each hat. This is a Safety Clean sponsor of NASCAR hat. This is a beautiful sport. It's an American tradition that's been around for about 60 years. It has a beautiful history, American history. Mm. And yeah, people have
Safety Clean.
Safety Clean is a full lubrication product.
Right, yeah, for cars, yes. Race car. Okay, let's see. Okay, do I wear a hat?
Go for it.
Wear it. The cat hat head. Well, I've been driving cars since I've been like out of the womb, basically. I started out driving cars. First thing I did when I woke up this morning, I got in my Ferrari. It's not actually a Ferrari, but it looks like a Ferrari. And if you don't remember the Kentucky Derby, they race horses, but I race cars. And cars are like oxygen. You know, once you get in that car, you just drive as fast as you can. Basically, NASCAR. NASCAR is. My name is Dale Earnhardt.
Yeah.
Dale Earnhardt. Yes. And I really like cars because it's a sense of freedom. And you're on the road and you're at any point you could die. You're risking your life to win the ultimate prize. And so you're driving down the road and you're hoping this is not your last day that you can drive a car. And you smell the tires burning, you smell the, you know, the fresh leather seats that you're riding in. So it's the life that I've chosen for myself. And driving a NASCAR is like it's not a hobby, it's my life. And so I hope I can convey just the passion that I have for racing cars, and maybe you'll see me out there someday. See me out there on the tracks. So.
Thank you, Prada, for skirting that fine line between life and death, between speed and fiery collapse.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you for volunteering here and being so excited.
Hello. found this hat in my grandmother's storage unit, and it reminds me of a different time. Maybe she wore it, maybe her husband. Maybe it's just one of those mysteries that ended up in her attic, but it contains a lot of mystery to me. It could be from the Wild West. It could be from my great-great-grandparents who fought in the Revolution or Civil War. It could be something someone just picked out to keep the sun off. It could be someone's whole life. They could have worn this hat for years and years, and then somehow ended up in her house. I don't know the stories behind this hat, but I like the mystery. Thank you.
Are you sure they're that you don't want to keep the hat? You seem like you quite bonded with it. And that's all we have time for tonight. Please join me in welcoming up our Table Topics Evaluator. Or let's vote first for our favorite Table Topics speaker so we can get one more time. Madam Timer, did all of our Table Topics speakers qualify? Mr. Timer, Mr. Assistant Timer.
Yes, they all qualified. Their names are Deward, Prana, and Pia.
Please vote for Deward, Prana, or Pia. And now, for one night only, it is my pleasure to call up our Table Topics Evaluator, Miss Andal Krishna.
Good evening, everyone. The first speaker tonight was Jude. I like the way he took on. He had a good start. He quickly started with the assimilation of his thoughts, and then he started his topic. The black hat that he had in his hand, he put it on his head, and he started talking about the role that he was playing, and trying to connect with the table topic master, and how he was connecting with the party and how he wanted to imitate him. And he had a good introduction, body, and conclusion. The one suggestion I would say that if he could have come in front and then had connected with the audience rather than having more connected to the Toastmaster. Next was Prana. I think even he took a media start. He didn't take much of his time to prepare or get ready with the topic. He immediately jumped into the topic and he started his speech. He had a good flow and he was building up as he was getting his story constructed, talking about the race cars and how he started to drive cars since when he came out of his mother's womb. I like that way he said that. And then one suggestion I would say for Prana would be that he could have used the stage rather than standing in one spot. Next speaker for was Pia. She had cowboy hat and she took her time to assimilate her thoughts, but she did give a nice story with a good introduction and body and conclusion. She brought the story like how she was thinking it could be this or this or this. She had different stories to connect the history of the hat. So I liked it the way she did it. And one suggestion again would be, if it would have been good if you would have had your hat on your head and then maybe move more, use the stage more. Thank you.
Mr. Timer, which of our evaluators qualified?
We had two evaluators qualified. They were Duard and Andal.
Duard and Andal. Please take a minute to vote for the best evaluator. And now for the report section of the meeting. Mr. Timer, could you please give us your report?
For the prepared speeches, Prana was 6 minutes 41 seconds, Jean 24 minutes 58 seconds. Table topics, Duard a minute 15, Prana a minute 57, Pia a minute 25. Evaluators, Emery was 3 minutes 35 seconds, Duard was 3 minutes, and Andal was 3 minutes and 1 second.
Cool.
6 minutes, 41 seconds.
Okay, thank you. Madam Grammarian, could you please give us your report? Please give us the odd counter report.
Everyone pretty well did very good, except for a few odd and ums. Prana had 3 1 7 so's, 2 and 1 pause. Of the beats, and I think Will had 1 and 1 four star. Pia had
1 odd and 1 0. That's it. Will Burns, 1 minute to make us laugh.
Young doctor was just setting up his first office when his secretary told him there was a man outside to see him. The doctor wanted to make a good first impression by having this man think he was successful and very busy. Always important for a starting doctor. He told his secretary to show the man in. At that moment, the doctor picked up his telephone and pretended to be having a conversation with a patient. This went on for some time. The man waited until the conversation was over. Then the doctor put his telephone down and said, "Can I help you?" To which the man replied, "No, I'm just here to connect your telephone."
Thank you. Thank you, Will. Now it's time to evaluate the evaluators. Emery evaluated Prana's speech. In the introduction, he did all the right things. He greeted the audience. He said which speech manual it was, project number, project title, intro, and objectives. Very good. When you went to do the evaluation, again, introduced yourself to the audience, greeted the audience. You started off your evaluation with a very strong statement, congratulating Prana on his strongest performance, how he exhibited a lot of skill and self-confidence. Very good opening, and I happen to agree with it. I think that was about your strongest speech, Prana. You went through the manual point by point, and you, some of your comments on the objectives in the manual, some were praising, and some offered objective criticism. Example, it wasn't, could have been a little clearer. Use the analogy of David versus Goliath in the speech, not many characters, and you talked about it did have a twist and a moral to prepare for. You ended with a suggestion how you have a clear opening body and close, and you close very strongly, which was good. One suggestion I have for you, when you give the evaluation part, again, remind people what the speech was, and just a summary of the objectives. That way they can be thinking of that while you're going through it. Doer, you evaluated Jean's speech. Again, in the beginning you greeted the audience, gave the title of the speech, the manual, all the correct things. And your evaluation was kind of a combination of going through the manual and your own opinions or your own views on it, which I think is just as effective. You started it out asking a question, who better to give a speech, officer than Jean, having been in this position for so long. You complimented Jean on her passion for the club, her humor, very good use of body language, and how the speech made progress, how it built towards kind of the punchline, the hook. If I were to make a suggestion for you, it would be when you first start the evaluation, again, mention what the objectives of the speech are. Andal, you did what I think is the hardest thing to do in Toastmasters, is to give an evaluation of table topics, but you did an excellent job. For each speaker, you pointed out two or three things that you liked, and plus you gave each one an area to improve. You spoke slowly and you fit everything in. It was a very well-measured speech. Usually I'm trying to write things down and think and I'm going crazy up here, but you did it very calmly and very effectively. And now I'd like to call on the Toastmaster, Art Atkinson.
Thank you, Rick. Now it's my opportunity to present the awards for the evening. We have, first of all, it's not here on the table, but we have a best speaker of the evening, Jean Symington Craig. What I have for you is no ribbon.
That's right, that's all right. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, may I hear a drum roll for best evaluator? Your job. Well done. Thanks, sir. Great bookmarks. And now a drum roll for this table topic. Again, your job. Stepping into some sort of an accent that was, you weren't able to sustain it through the whole
right.
talk, but that was the best start of a talk that I think you've ever done. That was fabulous.
Yep, that's what I do. I am. Ask our
And now I'll call upon our club president to close the meeting.
Yeah. You got it right.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Th
We'll see you next week. Oh, so we're not too far off.
3 minutes.
We're 3 minutes off. That's not too bad at all. Okay. Your little slips that I am wanting to get for our nominating committee. Again, correct filling out is putting your name at the top so I know who it is that's got this, and then your 1, 2, and 3, and then some comments on the bottom. If we, you know, you're heading off to the South Seas in 3 months for an extended time, you may not be the best person to be an officer for us. Okay. All right. All right. Any questions on that? That piece of paper? Good. I want to see them out here on the table, perhaps. You could just line them up there. And please see Rick if you for scheduling your speeches. We are moving right along. And now that he's back, it's really good. We can get scheduled and keep moving. All right. Thank you. With that, we'll call the meeting adjourned. Please stay, members, and help put together the room.